The fact that this is included in this movie is the reason enough for you to watch it. We live in a world where there are so much expectations. The struggle to be the best, to conquer your predecessors and make something great is real. We also tend to think that the world constantly should become better, that businesses should grow endlessly, and everything just kinda levels up. This is the reason why in times of struggle, just like now, we get even more confused that this utopic idea just isn't true. Maybe, just maybe, we don't live in the best version of the world that has ever been. But this also is a trap. This is where nostalgia comes from. The idealization of better times in past, which may have been better, but also may not have been better. You know, memories are not the most reliable source. Truth is always somewhere in between, but it's also hard to grasp because truth isn't just hard statistics of some thing which may represent the state of the world. It is also a feeling that everything is fine, but to catch a feeling, it's not a thing you just do. It comes or it doesn't come, and you don't have any control over it. World is more irrational than rational, but what does all this have to do with this movie? This movie is more irrational than rational, but still, it works, because it gives the feeling that not everything should meet the expectations, not everything should strive to be the greatest thing ever. And art is just that. Art exists for the sake of existing, not for some specific purpose. Just like the life itself exists for the sake of existing. Movies usually have some specific purpose, some expectations to meet, and there are pretty determined routes to follow for achieving this. And this is the reason why everything feels so alike and so well crafted that it becomes incredibly boring. But I don't think that rules are bad. Rules are incredibly good. We built our civilization following rules. There is a thin line between being a revolutionary and being just a madman who needs to be put down as fast as possible. And this is the thing about this movie. It breaks enough rules to make it feel different, to make it fresh and fun. But at the same time it follows enough rules to not be some super underground art movie no one understands. And this also the case with Nicolas Cage himself. I think he is one of the best actors because of this. He is weird, but he is good weird. Cage breaks the rules, but not enough of them to become unacceptable. Movie trailers are invented to market the movie, to show us a glimpse of what the movie is. I always watch trailers and I am almost certain that you also watch them. Usually I also check the rating in IMDb. You may also check the Rotten Tomatoes or some other sites or simply get opinions from friends. And all this is normal behavior, but inherently it ruins the experience of watching the movie for yourself or any other experience in a matter of fact you get too much opinions on before experiencing it yourself. But this is a double-edged sword, of course, because opinions from many people gives us the general impression of the world and of what is good and what is not good. In case of this movie, I watched the trailer, but I avoided checking the IMDb rating. I'm a Nicolas Cage fan, so I think I did the right thing. It doesn't matter what others may think, if I like something or if I don't. And I think we should strive for this more. If something turns out to be good, not knowing about it before makes it more meaningful in the end. I think I have to explain the core concept of this movie. The movie works at all because it is a movie about Nicolas Cage starring Nicolas Cage. But it's not a biography by no means. It's completely fictional. It's a weird fourth wall breaking action comedy poking fun of itself. And this is probably the most objective way how to describe it. I think that this is an easy way how to make full length movie boring. But this film has driving plot, so I didn't find the movie boring or dragging in any way, and that is a very good thing. I tried to imagine other actors starring Cage, but that wouldn't have worked. The only way for this movie to be was with Nick Cage. It feels like an extended meme regarding him, and it's great. The selling factor of this movie obviously is the nostalgia factor and the fanbase of Nick Cage, but it would be too simple to describe it like this. Although one is true, the other is not that important. The importance of Cage himself I have already described, but the nostalgia factor is not that important here. For me, this movie didn't feel nostalgic, and that's good. It builds on that, but gives new and fresh impression of itself. I would like to tell you about the scene that this movie has. Two main characters, one of them being Cage obviously, giving compliments to each other about how good their shoes look, eventually exchanging them and then giving more compliments. What an absurd, unimportant scene. But it simply works here, and this is due to the fact that the actors make it work. I would like to acknowledge Pedro Pascal here, because his chemistry with Nicolas Cage is great. He is other main character in the movie. For some reason, unbearable weight of massive talent makes me remember The Big Lebowski. This has similar vibes, but with Nick Cage, and I love it. The high budget and good cinematography also helps a lot this movie. It has gorgeous backgrounds which are supposed to be in Spain, but the movie is actually filmed in Croatia. I don't care about this though, because the movie does look good. Of course, it's a risky business, but there should be more high budget weird movies. This is the thing we need and what we have lost. Everything is so well marketed, crafted and analyzed that the soul is being sucked out of the things, but this still has it. Bookmakers predicting success of movies and songs just feels kind of wrong. I don't need their opinions, I want to have my own. If you would dissect unbearable weight of massive talent bit by bit, it wouldn't be any good. But altogether it becomes a thing, and you can't objectively evaluate this. It just feels right, and this is the core concept of the art itself. I refuse to give this movie any rating. I like to rate stuff actually, but not everything is meant and should be rated. Sometimes things should be described simply, I like it or I don't like it. And I like this movie, but that doesn't mean that you should necessarily go and watch it. The main factor why you should watch this movie is that if you are at least a little bit of a Nick Cage fan, only then this movie makes sense, otherwise it would be pretty confusing, I guess. This is it for my rambling about this movie. Thank you for watching.